Do you have an installment loan that you are personally responsible for? This video will show you how to set up QuickBooks Online to manage your mortgage, car payments, or any other kind of installment loan. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Now you may well ask, what are installment loans? Well, first, it's any long-term loan that you make equal monthly payments to pay off. Usually it's for a house, like a mortgage, or a car loan, or any other long-term loan that the individual is responsible for. Only a part of each monthly payment reduces the balance of the loan. The rest of the payment is kept by the lender as interest that they earned from you. Although the monthly payment is the same each month, the amount of interest and principal reduction for each payment will change from month to month. And the last property or attribute about an installment loan that makes it an installment loan? The lender is responsible for providing a schedule or chart that tells the borrower how much of each payment is interest and how much of each payment reduces the principal balance. Now this video is only setting up for the loan. Each installment loan must have an account in the chart of accounts to represent the balance of what is owed on the loan. The account must be a long-term liability type of account. You must also have an account in your chart of accounts to record the interest expense that you pay along with payments to reduce the balance. First, we need to fix our mortgage account. Our mortgage account we put on as an expense, and that's not correct. It was the wrong account type in the prior video when we set up the chart of accounts. Let's go and fix it. We can click Accounting, Chart of Accounts, and then scroll down to the expense section because we have it improperly recorded as an expense. You see, mortgage is not an expense. It's a long-term liability. So on the same row, we click the pull-down arrow and we click Edit. Now, it's not an expense. We have to instead choose long-term liability. Okay, long-term liability. Now, there are several detail types, but you can just click other long-term liability and that's fine. But keep the name mortgage so that you know this represents the balance of what we owe to the lender. Save and close. Yes. Okay, now we also want to make sure that we have an account in the chart of accounts for interest expense. And that was one of the accounts that QuickBooks Online already set up for us. If you scroll carefully, you'll see that there is an account called Interest Paid. And that was already provided for us as one of our expense accounts that was already in the chart of accounts when we joined QuickBooks Online. So what happens when you take an installment loan? Well, first, the money goes from the institution that you're borrowing from to you, and it stays in your bank account until the day that you pay for the house or the car or the nice little shack that you want to buy to retire. But you should be aware that before you pay for the asset that you borrowed the money for, the money is in your bank account. For example, Let's imagine on April 17th, 2021, you borrowed an $80,000 mortgage from M&T Bank. All the money was deposited into your M&T Bank account on April 17. You will pay for the house later. So that's a very simple transaction to record. We know that you can go to the M&T register and go across the row and click View Register, and you would record this like any other transaction in the register. So all you have to do is click Add Deposit. Now the date of this deposit, because this is money that you borrowed from the bank and put into your M&T bank account, that was April 17th of 2021, and you don't have to put the bank, but you do have to put the account. And in this case, the account is the mortgage. It's the long-term liability that represents the balance that you owe. And we are in the M&T register, so this is therefore a deposit to the M&T register. Push tab, and that's all you have to do to record it. Slide to the right and then click Save. Now let's take a look at the results. When we click Reports and we click Custom Reports, Trial Balance, you can see there's a big fat $80,000 mortgage, and you can see $80,000 has been added to the M&T bank account. Now, you should know that even if you do not pay for the house and the money stays in your bank account, you still must make monthly mortgage payments. Your bank will give you a schedule of payments that will show the amount of interest and principal for each payment. And that's called an amortization table. And we will talk more about that and actually making the monthly payments in the next video that follows.